First of all, congratulations, guys. I really enjoyed the film. And I think it's a very relatable story because we all face those, you know, moments in life that we are trying to figure everything out.
Yeah.
If you could give one advice to your character, what that would be?
Ooh,
I think I would, so my character Erin is very mature for her age, and she's very much a planner. And she thinks that, you know, she feels the need to do certain things because of a certain timeline that's been suggested to her. And I think over the course of the film, she starts to realize that it's really more important to live in the moment and be present and trust your feelings more than the plan. And so I would just tell her to follow her heart and not think so much, which is actually really good advice for myself, too.
Yeah,
it's adorable.
Aww.
Yeah, I think for me, I would definitely, I would tell Alec to just feel how he feels, you know? Sometimes, like, when we try to run away from how we're feeling, we like feel like we're just going backwards in life. I think it's okay to just accept where we are in the moment, how I'm feeling about this person or this situation or circumstance I'm in, and embrace it. And it's okay, you know what I mean? And then that's how you can move forward versus running away from those feelings, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thanks, bud. Probably be more honest with whoever you're talking to.
I like that one for your character.
Yeah, he kind of messed with Halston here, and I don't think intentionally, but you know, yeah. he could have easily been way more honest. I think that's pretty good advice.
Mm-hmm. And I think with Foster, you know, he spends the whole movie trying to be the person he thinks that girl will want him to be, so he can hook up with her, you know? So he kind of changes his outfits, he changes his look.
Yeah.
And he's kind of acting the entire movie. And I think, I would say, it's really one of the hardest things is to just be yourself and be comfortable in your own skin. I think, to me, that's like, any person, that's the thing I'm most attracted to, I think, is the sexiest, when somebody's comfortable in their own skin.
The movie's gonna be on Netflix, so my question is, at what point in a new relationship it is okay for you to tell the other person, you know, you want to come home and watch a Netflix movie with me? Is that like a, second date?
I think that's phase
thing?
One nowadays, man. That's,
yeah.
That's like the...
That is the date
isn't
nowadays.
Isn't that the
man.
Date, the first date nowadays?
I don't know. I feel like it's a feeling. It's a vibe. Sometimes mm-hmm. people click faster than like other couples would, or you know, sometimes it takes a little longer. It depends on the person, I think.
I'm learning a lot about all of these boys today.
I'm just saying, because I just feel like some dates, if you click fast, you may move a little faster.
I usually just say you up, Netflix question mark.
Give me you.
I'm kidding. No, I think yeah.
Just emojis. Just emojis. No.
Exactly. Very direct. Yeah. Jacob had it. He's like, I think the most important thing is just like, just be honest and real, and usually won't get into trouble that way.
Mm. Awesome. And have a great internet connection. That's always important.
Very,
you know,
yeah.
Things low.
Very
and,
true.
No,
I agree.
That's not cool.
Yeah, but then you get to talk, you know? Things are
loading.
I
like
you get to like know each other, get to know each other a little bit.
I'm just kidding.
Stop. So much cool
watch
advice, guys.
Do you want to come over and watch some Netflix with me?
What are we watching?
Whatever.
The last summer.
The last summer.
Netflix this Friday. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.